Hey guys, what is up and welcome back to my channel. So today I want to talk to you guys about the YouTube algorithm and just a little bit more about YouTube SEO, and especially how you can use it as a beginner YouTuber. Now, I got my start in the digital marketing industry. The first type of SEO I learned was Google SEO, which I honestly think is the most complicated type that you could have learned first. So I got my start with Google SEO, moved to Pinterest SEO, and as soon as I got on YouTube, I was like, I have to learn YouTube SEO because I am like a junkie for algorithms. I love understanding how they work. So if you know nothing about the YouTube algorithm, basically YouTube uses this algorithm to help determine what videos are going to rank in search, as well as what videos are going to be placed where on the platform for each individual user. So what appears on your home feed is obviously very different from what appears on my home feed, and that is all done because of the algorithm. Now, I've heard small YouTubers say that YouTube doesn't work for small YouTubers, and I don't honestly believe that that is true. I want to share with you how you can make the algorithm work for you as a small YouTuber to get those views, to get those subscribers by making YouTube work for you. Now, as most of you already know, I have been on YouTube for 2 years, and at this point, I still only have 3,000 subscribers, and you may have less subscribers and think that that's absolutely amazing, but I would still say that I am definitely much so a small YouTuber. And recently, I ended up having something really, really cool happen where the algorithm is totally working for me. And for a while, I was so focused on appearing in YouTube search and using the strategy that I'm about to share with you guys that it ended up paying off so well for me, and now I'm appearing on people's home pages. So I want to share exactly how I've been using the algorithm, how it's worked for me, and how I am now at the point where I am generating, yesterday I ended up generating over 100 subscribers because YouTube is recommending one of my YouTube videos. So make sure you stick around because this video is loaded with information, and I am so excited to share these tips with you guys. Here's the deal with YouTube. They obviously want to keep people on the platform for longer to make their platform as successful as possible. So the longer people are on YouTube, the better their stats are, plus the more ads they watch, which means more money YouTube ends up making. So they're only going to recommend videos that they think the user is actually going to watch. And if I'm being completely honest with you guys, it's going to be nearly impossible to appear on the trending page, especially as a small YouTuber. It's going to be pretty hard to appear on someone's home page unless they have already watched your videos in the past. It's going to be hard to appear in the right-hand side, that suggested bar section, unless it is one of your videos and you've become really, really good at niching down. And then when it comes to the subscription page, if you only have 10 subscribers, you are only appearing on 10 people's subscription page. So the main thing that I want you guys to focus on is search. I honestly believe that as a small YouTuber, your best place to push your efforts is within the search. So let me explain. Because there are several factors that go into the YouTube algorithm, it shouldn't be a surprise that some of them you actually can't control. And especially because YouTube tries to provide a unique experience for every single user. I mean, you can't determine what videos someone has watched in the past, how they've interacted with those videos, meaning if they gave them a thumbs up or a thumbs down, what channels they're already subscribed to, as well as what searches they've completed on YouTube. You really don't have any control over that, so I wouldn't worry about it. But when it comes to appearing in YouTube search, the main thing that you want to pay attention to, or I guess I should say the first thing that you want to pay attention to, is your keywords. It is going to be because of your keyword placement and targeting the right keywords that you actually appear in search. Now, obviously, there are a lot of other factors that YouTube takes into consideration, but to just appear in a search, you want to make sure that you are targeting the right keywords and placing those keywords in the right spots. Now, I do have another YouTube video for you guys that I think you would enjoy in terms of finding keywords and placing keywords within your YouTube videos, and I will include that right here for you guys, as well as in the description bar down below. I don't want to waste too much time here reiterating what I said in that video, but the main thing you want to focus on is targeting long tail keywords, specific keywords that you can actually rank for. You don't want to target the basic keywords that already have a lot of competition, and obviously more successful channels are going to appear higher than you. You want to target more niche specific keywords that you actually have an opportunity appearing for. And then once you have the keywords that you know you want to target, you want to include those keywords in your title, in your description, in your tags, and in what you say in your YouTube video. Now, once you're appearing in search, that's not enough, honestly, guys, because there are those other factors that you need to take into consideration. And one of those is your click-through rate. And this all comes down to your thumbnail. So let me break this down for you guys. If YouTube is recommending your video in search, they want to make sure that people are actually clicking on it. If they recommend your video 100 times in search and only one person ends up clicking on it, they're not going to continue to recommend that video because obviously people aren't interested in it. So if you are doing everything you can to make sure that you are appearing in search, but your thumbnail stinks and your title stinks and no one is actually clicking through to your YouTube video, that is hurting you from getting more views on YouTube. So your thumbnail honestly does matter, and you want to make sure that you're including a high quality thumbnail that someone wants to click on, as well as your title. Guys, I do not like saying use clickbait, but if you do use clickbait, make sure that you live up to it in your YouTube video, because that is another one of the ranking factors that we need to talk about. So YouTube takes into consideration your keywords. They take into consideration your click-through rate, but one of the main things that they pay attention to is your engagement. They like to see that people actually like the content that they are recommending. So the longer someone watches your YouTube videos, the more likes you have, the more comments you have, the more likely YouTube is actually going to recommend it, because they want to recommend content that people are honestly actually enjoying. So keywords get you to appear in search. Your click-through rate, your thumbnail, your title actually get people to watch your video, but then your video has to be freaking amazing to keep people watching it, as well as liking it, as well as leaving comments in the comment section down below. So those are the main factors that you really want to pay attention to. And honestly, your engagement is so, so important to your success on your YouTube channel. And let me explain why. So these are my analytics over the past year in terms of traffic source driving me the most views to my YouTube channel. And for the longest time, I was focused on YouTube search because I knew that it could provide me real results, especially as a beginner YouTuber. And you can see this blue line here, that is because of YouTube search. And for a while, I was hovering pretty straight. I ended up going up a little bit, but you can see it right here. You notice that these four lines on the bottom, they're all pretty close together. They're not really driving me any views to my YouTube channel. Until recently, they started breaking apart. And actually this past week, the browse features have ended up driving me 4,000 views to my YouTube channel, compared to search is still driving me 3,000 views to my YouTube channel. Now, if you're curious what the browse features are, let's take a look. The main source of traffic this past week was because my videos were appearing on people's home pages. And actually, YouTube ended up driving me almost 4,000 views to my YouTube channel just because they were recommending my video on people's home pages. And this wouldn't have been made possible if I didn't pay attention to YouTube search, YouTube SEO. Guys, my keywords are what was able to make my YouTube videos to rank in search, but then it was because of the engagement and the success of that video within YouTube search that YouTube ended up picking it up. So let's specifically take a look at the video that's performing the best for me right now, because I want you guys to understand the analytics and the reasoning behind this so that you guys can best channel your efforts in a way that's actually going to work for you. So this is the video that YouTube ended up picking up and is now promoting on people's home pages. And at the beginning, the very first day it launched, it got 130 views, not bad, but you can see the days after, I mean, one of these days it only got 16, another day it only got 10. And for a while it was doing okay. I mean, we were on a steady increase for a while, but it wasn't until about here, which is actually within the past week, that it started to really blow up. And the main reason for that, if we take a look at the traffic source for this one YouTube video, is because you can see I was appearing in search. I wasn't doing bad. But then this spike is because of those browse features. It's because YouTube started recommending it on people's home pages. And it's because of the engagement on this YouTube video. Right now, this YouTube video has over 18,000 views. It has generated 656 comments, as well as 1,091 likes. It is because YouTube realized that people actually were enjoying this video, people were engaging with this video, that they realized it was a high quality video. And if people weren't specifically searching for it, no one was going to see this video. So they started to recommend it on people's home pages. So I want to take a look at the funnel provided by YouTube within your analytics, because this is really going to drive home what I'm saying. So if you guys ever want to take a look at this on your own videos, you can go to one specific video on your YouTube channel, click on analytics, go to reach, and then right down here, this is the funnel that I am talking about. Now, this goes back to exactly what I was saying in terms of click-through rate and the success of your video in terms of actually appearing, people clicking on it, people staying on it, and then the real success of your video. So right up top here, impressions, this video ended up getting 168,000 impressions on YouTube. And what that means is that it was shown on YouTube 168,000 times. So if I hover over this little eye icon, you can see that YouTube ended up recommending my content 34% of the time, and it was recommended on the homepage 23%, compared to the watch page was 10%. And if you see this little snippet right here, it says you can increase the chance of YouTube suggesting your content by increasing your click-through rate and your video watch time. So this was the number of impressions that I ended up getting on YouTube from this one YouTube video. And then you can see my click-through rate was 7.6%. Because of the click-through rate, it has ended up generating me 12,000 views based off of those impressions. So that is the importance of the click-through right there. If YouTube is recommending my video a lot and not a lot of people are actually clicking through it, they're not going to continue to recommend it. But if people are actually clicking on my video, YouTube is more likely to recommend it. But then it goes on even further, because the next level is the viewer watch time. You want to get people to watch your video for as long as possible. And I've continued to tell you guys that you want to make your videos as interesting as possible. And I've got a few tricks to make my videos interesting because I want people to watch my videos for longer. If people aren't watching your videos, guys, that's going to ruin your engagement and YouTube isn't going to want to recommend it in search in the future, as well as possibly on people's homepages. So for this video, the average duration was 4 minutes and 25 seconds. And I ended up going back to that point where I realized a lot of people were dropping off. And it was because I had one of those slides and I was switching. I was doing a transition within my video. And funny enough, I actually stopped doing those because I realized that that ended up losing viewers for me. So you can see right here, my average view duration was 4 minutes, 25 seconds. And because of that, I ended up generating 56,000 minutes of watch time based off of those impressions. So YouTube really does take this funnel into consideration to make sure that they are recommending videos that are actually going to perform well. Guys, YouTube does not want to recommend videos that aren't going to perform well on the YouTube platform. But the strategy that I used to get this one video to get picked up by YouTube only worked because I focused on appearing in YouTube search. So what can you do to appear better in YouTube search? First and foremost, guys, do your keyword research. Place your keywords in the right places. Then you need to think about your click-through rate. So make sure that your thumbnail is really good, as well as your titles, and that people actually want to click on your videos. When people click on your videos, do they actually like your videos? Are you encouraging them to give it a thumbs up, to leave comments in the comment section down below? Feel free to ask them questions. The more engagement you have on your videos, the better, as well as the longer someone watches your videos, the better. Now, those are the main ranking factors that you can really take into your own hands, that you can work on to improve to make sure that you are actually ranking in search. But beyond that, there truly is more that you can do to help your videos. So let's say that people are starting to leave comments in your videos. Guys, reply to every single comment, because every comment that you leave creates a new comment and it increases your engagement rate. So let's say that you already have 5 comments on your YouTube video, but you aren't responding to those comments. Guys, if you respond to every single comment, you automatically double the amount of comments on your YouTube video, which will more so trigger YouTube that you have got a better video that people are actually enjoying. You can also like your own videos and watch your video the whole way through to increase your watch time. Guys, whenever I launch a new YouTube video, I am the first person to watch it. I will watch it the whole entire way through so that it gives it a good status from the very beginning. And I will also thumbs up every single one of my YouTube videos, because that is one extra person to like my YouTube videos, which increases my engagement rate. Guys, engagement rate is so, so important on YouTube. And the other main thing that you want to focus on in terms of your YouTube strategy is niching down for one. You know that right-hand sidebar that I talked about before? The videos that are recommended over there are based off of what people are currently watching. So if I share more YouTube-related YouTube videos, I am more likely to get those videos to rank in the sidebar, which gets people to watch my videos for longer. As well as I include related videos in the description bar down below so that if anyone goes down there, they can watch other videos that I know that they are actually going to like. Having binge-worthy content on your YouTube channel, one, gets you more views. It gets you more watch time because people are sitting down and they're watching a ton of your YouTube videos at one point, and that's really, really great. Plus, the more videos someone watches, even if they're not subscribed to your channel, the more likely you're actually going to appear on their homepage as well as within search, because search for every person is not the same. So I don't like to pay attention to, oh, I'm appearing first in search, oh, I'm appearing 20th in search, because for every person it's going to be different. If you have watched my YouTube videos in the past, my videos are going to rank higher in search compared to someone else who has the same number of views and the same exact engagement rate. If you have watched my video compared to you've never watched theirs before, my video is actually going to rank higher. So the more videos that someone watches on your channel, honestly, the better. Niching down can help you so, so, so much. And then the last thing that I'm going to recommend you guys is upload consistently. And I'm sure if you've watched any other YouTube video before talking about YouTube SEO and your YouTube strategy, they're going to tell you that you need to upload consistently. And the main reason for this is so that your audience knows when you're uploading, they keep coming back for more. You create that kind of routine for someone and they get excited to watch your videos every time it's a Wednesday or whenever you upload. But the other reason is that the more content you upload to YouTube, the better opportunity you actually have appearing in search. That's the way I look at it. The more videos I have, the more videos that can rank in search, the more that can actually perform later on. I'm not worried about my views right off at the very beginning because like the video that I just showed you, it got okay views from the start, but it wasn't until a few months later that it ended up taking off. And it's because I was able to do my YouTube SEO and make sure that it would appear in search. So guys, if you're worried about your views and you're like, my videos aren't doing well right now, make sure that you are creating high quality videos and evergreen content that is going to perform for you in the long run. You don't know if 8 months down the line, YouTube is going to decide to pick up your video, rank it really high in search, and then put it on people's homepages. You have no idea. So continue creating content consistently, stick with it. And one of the comments that I end up replying back to most comments is keep going. Do not stop creating videos. Just keep going because the success will come. So that is it with this YouTube video. I'm really hoping that you guys liked it and found it helpful. I especially am just hoping that you understand the importance of ranking in search and how that can lead to more growth for your YouTube channel in the future. So if you like this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel down below. If you guys want to see any other YouTube related YouTube videos, please let me know in the comment section down below, as well as leave me your questions because that's kind of where I end up coming up with my YouTube video. So make sure you leave a comment, like this video, subscribe, and yeah, all the engagement things. Okay, bye guys.